Greetings and salutations and good evening, beautiful white positive people, all my brothers and sisters out there, lots of love to you. Blue Ninja here, one of many apostles, just like all of you out there. Coming to you on the evening of December 22nd. Christmas just around the corner. Tuesday today. Christmas is on Friday. And I just found out I'm not going to have to work on Christmas Day. But I'll be working every other day. So that's okay for me. It is dark out here. I'm in LA. Drove straight back from Vegas today. And now they're sending me out on another load to Arizona right away. So, but this LA traffic is killer. I'm on Highway 91. Anyone who knows Highway 91 in LA, I don't go on this highway that much, actually. Just here and there, but man, I guess rush hour on 91 is bad. This is like one of the worst I've seen. Lots of the highways are bad in Southern Cal, but you know, this is probably the worst. I mean, usually it's kind of moving. This is not even moving. This is crawling, barely. So that's what puts a damper on things, trucking, dealing with this. But anyway. Got some things I wanted to say to you all. First off, greetings to the lovely Wilhelmina Bear and your son, Wilhelmina Matthew. Greetings, my brother. Donning armor. Art acrobats. Mrs. Jess Horst, if she ever sees any of these. Irish Ice, 41 BMC. I gotta just start calling you Brad C. I'm so used to saying 41 BMC. It sounds pretty cool. Brad C. Hero in Minnesota. That I'm missing here. Foster, of course. Cannot forget Raymond Foster. That would be like forgetting to put the king down on the chessboard there. He is one of many kings we have in the white positive sphere. The great, the noble, the prince, the king, the knight, Sir Raymond Foster. I'm spacing out on the rest, some of the other ones of you all. Oh, we got Johnny Rev made a comment on my last video, I think. Thank you, my man. And glad to have you here checking out some of this stuff. As you can see, it's just kind of on the fly sometimes, just, you know, raw, unedited stuff. That's what I put out there, Blue Ninja style for white well-being. So Johnny Rev is a big name, of course. Jason Kuna, the great, the one and only, went to visit Johnny Rev. Told us about it. Of course, we probably heard it, all heard it, about their good times in Texas. That sounded awesome. So, what an honor, Johnny Rev, to have a comment from you. Really appreciate it, and lots of respect out to you, my brother. And I'm just spacing out on some of the other names, but you know, obviously love, respect, appreciation, admiration, and support to each and every one of you. I admire each and every one. I'm trying to hang on to your coattails, just following your all of your footsteps, do what I can. And all I can really do is talk. All I can really do from my stand, from my position, my humble position these days, driving a truck around, all I can really do is talk and give some real straight talk. And the way things are, the way I see things, reality out here on the ground. That's one thing I can offer, is a ground level perspective out on the battlefield. We're all on the battlefield, but, and, you know, I travel, so not as far and wide as I used to, but I see a variety of things. So, and, you know, sometimes you have some interesting experiences. A lot of times. I had one today. I had a really good one. Today, earlier this morning, and that's what I wanted to talk about here on this video. I want to share that and a couple other things that I saw today on the tube when I was in Vegas. I was at this big truck stop, North Las Vegas, right next to the Speedway. And before I left this morning, I went in there and I saw good old Fox News. And just right as soon as I looked at it, was something talking about an anti-racist manifesto that was supposedly found with like a child, I think. I don't know the details, but I think it was like some kid in school or something, supposedly found with a possession of an anti-racist manifesto. Again, I don't know the details. It could have been completely made up. We know anti-whites in the media, they will completely make stuff up like that. Before I get on to that, well, I'll get on to that right now. So that was what I see. I see this anti-racist manifesto, supposedly found to be in the possession of a young kid, I think. I don't know if the kid was white or non-white, but, and again, I would be not surprised at all if the entire story was completely fabricated. A manifesto, you know, a kid in school having a manifesto, anti-racist, it just seems crazy. But, nonetheless, with the extreme level of anti-whiteism, which can also be encoded as anti-racism, but by the anti-whites would say it as anti-racism. That's how they say it in their anti-white narrative. You know, because anti-racism is just anti-whiteism. Anti-racist is just anti-white. But they're using the derogatory slur for white people as, for two reasons. Number one, they want to be derogatory toward whites, any chance they have. Number two, it gives them a pretext, a justification to make us the bad guy. So when they say anti-racist, of course they just mean anti-white. With the cover, it's somehow okay. We uncover it and say, no, it's just anti-white. And make it sound and look as bad as it really is. So, I mean, a kid, a school kid having a, or whoever it may have been, supposedly having an anti-racist manifesto seems kind of crazy. But, nonetheless, with the level of anti-whiteism and how people are, like I've talked about, as we all know, people do, unfortunately, adopt a lot of the stuff that's in the anti-white media, the anti-white narrative. They just take it on, take it in, and they start using it. So, unfortunately, most people are just parrots, you know. Parrots, they just monkey see, monkey do, monkey hear, monkey say. Whatever they hear, they repeat. From the media, they just parrot it. You know, like parakeets, toucans. unfortunately, most people don't evaluate things. They just simply repeat what the media tells them. So, there's a big increase in people using that word, obviously, because of the anti-white media, unfortunately. So it could have very well been, as hyper anti-white as the anti-whites, anti-white media is right now, putting that into society at all-time high levels, it could be that people are picking it up. And you know, I've heard the word used plenty, like I talked about before, way more than I ever heard it in my lifetime, you know, these days. And so, who knows? Maybe some kid or something decided he was gonna virtue signal, which is actually villainy signaling, as we know, about being anti-racist or something. Who knows? It's possible. Of course, they're gonna call it a manifesto. It could have been scribble on a scrap piece of paper, and they're gonna blow that story up. Anything that makes whites look bad, anything they can use to harm whites, they will use. Now, anti-racist is kind of stating their position directly. You know, they're not, it's not necessarily demonizing whites, I would say, on that one, but it's coming out with their intent, which is to harm whites. Anti-racist. Anyone who writes an anti-racist memo or anything, they're going to put that on front center on the news. Fox. Because it's not necessarily making whites look bad. It's deriding whites, it's insulting whites, it's demeaning whites, and it is stating their position directly. It's a chance to harm whites. So they're gonna say, ooh, somebody's writing the anti-racist, we like that. Let's put that big on the news. Because that word racist is their word. They always want to put that on the news. They want to keep that word going, no matter how it's used. That R word. So if it's anti that, then great. They put it out there. Sounds good within the anti-white narrative, anti-racism. You know, racism is bad in their narrative. It sounds like a good thing to be anti-racist. So, you know, little do most people know that is code for anti-white. So that is going to promote more harm being done to white people. That is broadcasting anti-whiteism big in the sky on Fox News, encoded with the word racist, which gives the justification, the false justification to harm whites. It uses the derogatory term for whites, the anti-white slur, racist. Refers to us in a derogatory way. And a lot of people are unaware. The anti-whites that put that story on Fox are definitely aware, you know, as the creators of that word. And a lot of people, you know, out in the public may be aware too, that that's what they're doing. They're harming whites. They're anti, the anti-whites out in the public are going to eat that up. So they're going to say, yeah, let's get those races. Let's get those whites. So, I mean, just crazy. First thing I see, anti-racist manifesto, which is code for anti-white. You know, getting broadcast on Fox News. So, just fans the flames of anti-whiteism, essentially, for all the anti-whites out there. Also, the other point I'm going to make about that, this shows something like that, when you see something about anti-racism on Fox News, that shows you, shows everyone, the position of people that control that station and all the media, all the rest of the media as a whole. It reveals just one of many things that reveals who controls that media, big time media. It is controlled by people with a heavy bias against whites. A certain tribe of people that are radically anti-white, hate whites more than anything, want to erase us. That group of people, of anti-whites, controls the biggest media in the world, including Fox News. So, that kind of a story about a supposed anti-racist manifesto shows that perfectly. And what it shows is that the people behind those big fancy news channels are just as radically anti-white as some monster thug you would see on the street that's just ready to harm and kill whites at the first opportunity. Some thug, some monster on the streets that wants to commit crime against and harm whites. People wearing suits that own those news channels are the same way. They're just as nasty, if not nastier. They have destruction in their hearts. And so, but what they do is they present it all in a professional way. They know how to present things to make it look professional. They got these big news networks. They got these people that pay a lot of money to just mindlessly regurgitate what they tell them to, like zombies. And you look at those newscasters on Fox, those big channels, CNN, MSNBC, they look like they are hypnotized zombies. I mean, they're just eyes zoned out, looking at the teleprompter, just absolute zombies. Getting paid a lot of money by the anti-whites to put out the messages they want to put out. The anti-whites, they know how to, you know, present things in a professional looking manner with those fancy news stations with people dressed up real nice. Just because they're all dressed up real nice with makeup on, they got these big networks all over on every TV, not mean they're legitimate. Doesn't mean that they're not monstrously anti-white. They are. They're thugs at heart. Destructive, hateful thugs. They know what they're doing. Unfortunately, they know how to present things to make people give credence to it. But it's just a bunch of anti-white filth. Now, the other thing I noticed on Fox there was they were talking about, they had a bunch of commentators talking about, half of whom were non-white. This particular commentary, I noticed there was five anchors, two dark non-whites, and I think two or three white women. There were no white men on this political commentary piece on Fox, and I didn't really catch everything what they were saying, but they were talking about something about socialism, and how you know, being anti-socialism, stuff like that, how socialism is bad, socialism is the enemy. That's what we're going to see, you know, that's what people are going to see on Fox. They're going to say socialism is the real enemy. Socialists are the real enemy. And they're talking about that. They're talking about being anti-socialism. And that's great on Fox News. So, I just wanted to point out, of course, as we all know, that is a misdirection. Saying that, you know, focusing on socialism, saying that's the problem. Let's be conservatives on Fox and say that we're anti-socialists. You know, that is obviously, as we all know, misdirection. Away from the truth. What is the truth? The truth is that they are anti-white. That whole channel, people who control that channel are anti-white. Shauna Shaw does a good job spreading our dialectics, which is quite positive versus anti-white. That's the real dialectic. Fox News would have you believe it's conservative, capitalist versus socialist. Communist, Democrat. So they perpetuate that every single day, and a lot of people watch that news channel every single day. And if you watch something every single day, you're gonna think like that, whether you want to or not. anti-Trump. Fox News says it's those dang anti-Trumpers, anti-Trump, communist, socialist, Democrats. They're the problem. Those psychotic anti-Trumpers. Well, again, that's a kind of a new one to me. I haven't heard the media use that term anti-Trump. I'm sure it's been used for a while. But obviously that's misdirection. Also, you know, because as we know, it's not anti-Trumpers that are the problem. It's anti-whites. And so-called anti-Trumpers, whoever they're calling anti-Trumpers, you know, maybe Democrats, you know, the so-called anti-Trumpers are not attacking so-called pro-Trump people because they're pro-Trump. They're getting attacked because they're whites. That's why every white person gets attacked. Because they're white. Trump supporters, that's just one excuse. One of millions and millions to harm whites. Say, look, there's a white person. Is he a Trump supporter? Okay, use that as your excuse to attack him or her. Just an excuse, nothing more. So they're perpetuating that kind of terminology. Obviously, it's misdirection. The good thing is that it shows that they are listening to us using anti-white, using our terminology. They're radically, desperately trying to counteract what we are doing. And really, what they want to do is keep people away from the words that we use. They want to keep our words out because our words can only work for us. They cannot work against us. They cannot work for the anti-whites. There is no way that an anti-white can use our vocabulary against us. They can't use white positive. They can't use white well-being. They can't use going free. They can't use no white guilt. They can't use term anti-whites, because that will make them look like the bad guy. They are, as an anti-white. They can't use any of our words because our words keep us as the good guy, like Jason talks about. It makes them, the anti-whites, the bad guy, which is the truth of the situation. So they are using these other words, anti-Trump, anti-socialist, anti-this or that. Try to sort of replace, to counter and replace the words that we use, but they can't really counter our words. They're just trying to give people other words to use instead, keep our words out. So when we use our words, we win. Now, so on to a success story for today. So after that, I go out to my truck and I see a guy, a strong looking, a little bit older, white guy, and his lady, I assume his wife, that he met up with. The lady, I'll just call her his wife. His wife came in a little vehicle, pickup truck, and met him. He was driving a big rig. He stopped at the truck stop and she met him, came to meet him for lunch or something. They were just having a little break, eating lunch in their pickup truck. right, kind of in, you know, kind of real close to me, kind of in front of me. I saw them, and I just thought, man, these look like some good, strong, proud white people here. And the guy, man, I saw the back of his shirt, and he was wearing a shirt that said something about, you know, he was born in December, he's a grumpy old man, you know, he can't fight very well, he can't run very fast anymore, so, you know, if it comes to a fight, he'll just, the shirt said, you know, I can't run very fast, I can't fight very well anymore, I'm old and grumpy, so I'll just shoot you instead and be done with it, with a toy pistol with Nerf balls, of course, a toy gun with Nerf balls. But that's just what the shirt said, talking about, you know, defending our right to self-defense, our gun rights, and so forth, that kind of thing. And that's, you know, just one of those shirts that's in support of our right to self-defense, Second Amendment, using those particular weapons, those particular tools. And, you know, one of those shirts. And, you know, so this is a proud white man who is showing his support for the right to self-defense, being proud to have that right, you know. And I thought, okay, that's cool. He's got a shirt on that to me is very promising of a white positive man, and you know, and his woman there looked like a strong, tough country woman as well. And they were kind of, I needed to get out and just ask them to move their pickup truck a little bit so I could pull my big rig out. And so I just had that opportunity to talk to them. And I thought, oh, I'm going to have to talk to him anyway. I might as well bring up something about his shirt, which will be a nice lead in to white positive talk. So I said, hey folks, I'll need you to back up your pickup if I could, so I could pull out here. And they were real nice about it. I said, yeah, of course. And I said, by the way, sir, I like your shirt, you know. And it was like people commenting on the No White Guilt shirt sometimes. I was saying, I like your shirt, man, you know, gun rights stuff, and so many words. And he was like, thank you, you know, yeah, it's a lot of people like this shirt, and they give me compliments. And I said, yeah, it's pretty cool, you know. And I said, along those lines, you know, do you all notice, like, you know, it seems to me like things are so anti-white now. And right away, he just said, yep, they nodded their head and said, yes, totally agree, the man and the woman. They just nodded their heads, total agreement right from the beginning. And then that struck up a conversation. Where I said, yeah, you know, we whites have got to wake up and recognize that we are under attack. We had a good conversation, about 15-minute conversation, you know, pretty long conversation there, talking about a lot of things we see in the media and how all that stuff is anti-white. they'll talk about racism. Racist, I said, that's an anti-white slur. All that stuff you see is just an excuse to harm whites. It's all anti-white. You know, and they totally agreed. Had some stories to tell me themselves about the anti-whiteism that they're experiencing. The woman said she grew up in a small town in Colorado, out in the country. And I know Colorado, out in the country, has some real, you know, farming, ranching, cowboy towns out there in Colorado. I don't know if the guy was from there also, but, you know, seemed like Colorado ranching type people. And, anyhow, they're living in Vegas now, so I said, yeah, they were saying how anti-white it is in Vegas, basically, and I said, yeah, completely. You know, we're telling stories, sharing our stories, of all the anti-whiteism we've seen. And the white erasure, I said, you know, whites are being erased. And I used the G word as well. You know, we are, and they're just like, yeah, we are, man. And they were strong and proud and tough and totally agreed, yes, we need to defend ourselves. We are being attacked. What's interesting is I said, you know what? I said, whites just need the right words to defend ourselves. And they were ready to hear it. They said, yeah, they said, we just need the right words how to respond, you know, to these people, you know, when they're talking about racism and all this other stuff. They were telling me, they said, we just need to know how to come back at them, how to defend ourselves. What do we say? It was perfect. I said, yes, exactly. I said, everyone, all of us whites need to know what to say and how to respond. So they were responding perfectly in being ready to be equipped with our lexicon. So I said, you're so right. We just need the words. And I said, I'll tell you. Well, here's how you handle it. Here's what you say. And I remember the first time I heard Jason say that how we handle anti-whites is we call them anti-white. And I remember thinking, wow, that's it. That's the ticket. I can't wait to use that. And I told this to these people now. Same thing. I said, here's what you do. How you handle them, call them anti-white. You know, if they want to call you a racist, you say that's an anti-white slur, and you call them anti-white. Anybody who says anything derogatory towards white people, towards you, as white people, call them anti-white. Simple as that. Anti-white is the magic word for us. I said, that's how we win. Because every other thing that the media gives us, we lose. You know, we're talking about some of this stuff, and they totally agree. Yeah, none of that stuff works. I said, yep, what's going to work is using the word anti-white. You just call them anti-white. Whatever they want to say, whatever justification, pretext, conversation they want to get into, you just say, you're anti-white. If they want to talk about history, past and present, whatever reason they come up with, you say, I don't care what you're saying, you're anti-white. You know, I reject that, I'm a white person. You know, my family's white, my loved ones are white, my people are white. Are saying things against whites, you're anti-white. I don't like that. You know, so that's all you got to say. I told them that. They ate it up. They said, oh, okay, I'm going to remember that, anti-white. One guy wanted to put it on his shirt right there. It's an anti-white. Yeah, I want to add that to my shirt. You know, and it was perfect. It was a perfect conversation. It's exactly the way conversations should go with white people. They were so ready. They were just like, tell us what to say. Tell us, please. Exactly like a lot of us are when we discovered Jason and Going Free. We're all just ready. Tell us what to say. How do we handle this as whites? All these attacks. They were the same way. I said, here, you just say anti-white. And then I gave them the other words, no white guilt. You know, what are we? We are white positive. We're not white nationalists or white supremacists or any of that. We are white positive. What do? We work for white well-being. We support the well-being of white people. We work for and we serve white well-being. That's what we're for. We're for the well-being of whites. That's what we're all about. So I gave them all that stuff and explained that the reason that all works is because we're the good guys there. Anyone that disagrees with that, they're the bad guys. And then if they disagree, they're anti-white, you just call them anti-white. If they agree, then great. Then they're white positive to some degree. You know, but that puts us on the moral high ground, as Jason says. And any anti-white that disagrees, they have the moral low ground. So, you know, I gave that all to him, and then I said, kicker, if you want to find out the source for all this information and a lot more, get plugged into a white positive community, the white positive community, go to nowhiteguilt.org. So I gave the website, they wrote it down, nowhiteguilt.org. I told them there's a YouTube channel, you know, Jason's channel, No White Guilt, and gave them the resources there. I said that's going to plug you into all the white positive people out there, all the, you know, resources, etc. And they were eager. They wrote it down. So it was a beautiful thing. It's just, you know, it was just so simple and beautiful, and it was this great conversation. And, you know, there's so many opportunities now. You know, so I felt really good. I felt like, wow, I just got the message. I just saved another couple of white people. They're going to spread it to their families, their kids. You know, and you know, they're gonna be able to help other white people. They're gonna be able to defend themselves against anti-whites. You know, of any race, of any kind. And I just armed them up. I equipped them to defend themselves, metaphorically, using words to effectively defend themselves against anti-whites, and gave them the tools to reach other whites and set other white people free. So they're going to spread it. They're going to get tapped into our community. They're going to learn more and more. They're going to, you know, and it just makes you feel like every time you do that, every time we share the message with someone, the gospel, white well-being to save our kind. Every time we do that, we are saving our people. We are taking a step contributing towards the salvation, literally, of our people. Every time we tell someone about that, about going through, about the white positive sphere in our lexicon, it's, you know, it's literally saving our people every time we do. So, you know, we can all feel really good every time we do that. Taking real steps to contribute to the well-being of white people, to the recapturing of our destiny as Western. especially when people receive it so well. And again, you know, they're going to share it, pass it on, spread it themselves, and save others. They're going to save their family, they're going to save their friends, others that they know. Other beautiful white Western people, strong, and so, you know, it was a beautiful thing, it was an awesome thing, it was very encouraging. That's how it works. And so that's about it, just a success story there. And I was going to say, it's such a ripe time to share it because, you know, just like these people, as we all know, so many whites are just so ready for this message. They're so ready for it because they're seeing all the anti-whites. Every time you see someone with a American flag or a, you know, a blue, black and blue, whatever, American flag, you know, supporting the police, or something about gun rights, Second Amendment, right to self-defense, a lot of these pro-American messages, whenever you see whites displaying that, as we know, they are very ripe for going free, for message of white well-being, to become white positive. They're very ripe and ready for that. Because what they're trying to do, as we know, talked about before, those people that are really expressing their pro-American spirit and sentiment, they're wearing it on their sleeves, they're putting it up big on their cars, trucks, houses, they're displaying it. We all know they are trying to defend themselves as whites. That's what they're trying to do, whether they realize it or not. This couple that I talked to today was totally aware. They were aware. They absolutely knew right away. When I said all this stuff in the media is anti-white, they just agreed right away. They knew it was an attack on whites. There was no disagreement from them whatsoever with anything I said. I said, we're being attacked because we're white. Nothing else. And they said, yep. You know, absolutely. So, a lot of people are like that, or similar to that level, where you're trying to defend that when you see someone with an American flag of any kind, that kind of stuff. They are trying to defend themselves as whites, which means they are ready. They are totally ready. They see there's a problem. They're trying to do something about it. They are so ready for the message of white well-being, for the message of going free. We just gotta say, hey, okay, right on, with your American flag, with your supporting of the Second Amendment or whatever, Constitution, whatever it may be, right on. More power to you. Let me tell you also, and then, you know, you strike up the conversation about anti-whiteism. So that's what it is. You want to know how to defend yourself? Here it is. Defend yourself as a white person. Because that's why we're being attacked. Because we're white, so we need to defend because we're white. Here's how you do it. You know, you call them anti-white. You call yourself white positive. Use these terms. They're so ready, they will receive it, a lot of them just adopted right away. This couple I talked to today, they were some tough cowboy, like I said, country folk. I know they're going to adopt it. They're straight Western. They were as Western as could be. I mean, they were cool. Just on the farm, you know. And there are people like them are going to adopt it right away. There's a lot of whites out there like them, ready. So when you see someone, everyone, with an American flag of any kind, or any of that stuff, talking about constitutional rights and this and that, you tell them, hey, right on, you know, I like your shirt, I like your sticker, I like your, you know, display, whatever. poster that you got there, whatever it may be, the flag, it's pretty cool. You know, your Greek flag, your American flag, your Canadian flag, whatever it may be, Western. That's real cool. You want to know what else is really cool? Going free with no white guilt, serving white well-being, becoming white positive, and defeating anti-whites. Because anti-whiteism is the problem. That's what else is super cool. So why don't you join up, go to nowhiteguilt.org, get plugged in to the rest of the whites that are defending our kind and working for the recapture of our destiny as the West, as Western people. And they're going to be like, wow, yeah, right on, go check that out. You know, these people today were just like, absolutely, we're going to check that out. Damn Skippy. I said, we're being attacked. They said, damn Skippy we are. We want a defense, and here's what you do. And they're going to use the word anti-white as soon as they possibly can. They were telling me about people they already wanted to use it on. They were planning on, you know, calling anti-whites that they had encountered before. They couldn't wait. Lots of people are like this. You know, it's easy for us nowadays to get this message to our white, beautiful, strong brothers and sisters. Easier than ever before. Get into them, so let's all keep it up, everybody. I'm gonna get to my destination here pretty soon, which is just looking for an empty trailer. Waste a lot of time. Well, it takes a lot of time to do that, unfortunately. Anyway, gotta run around a little bit more in LA before I head out to Arizona, and I'm gonna be burning some midnight juice, I think, but that's my story, that's my success story. Anti-whiteism I saw on the tube on Fox, and my success story for the day. So that's how we counteract all the anti-whiteism. Every time we see something disgustingly anti-white on TV, in the news, in the media of any kind, go out there and get the message to another white person. Set them free. May we all be free, God is our witness. Because as I've said before, JFK said, we will live as we were born to live, free and independent, as whites. Free men and women, we were born, free men and women, we are, and will be forevermore, as whites, as the West. No one has the West in us but white people. We are the only ones. So by God, let us preserve and keep this blessing. Let us carry it forth. So that this fire that burns within our Western spirit, our Western bio spirit, continues to burn forevermore. I love you all. God bless you. Stay white positive. Stay strong. Let's keep going. Three. We're going to end here. Take it out. A little song. I thought it was a song about work. It's not so much about work, because that's what I'm doing. I'm working my butt off. But this is a song about, I'm going to dedicate to those anti-whites. You know, how are we going to work out this anti-whiteism? How do we deal with it? Like the song says, how are we going to work this out? We don't know how we and them being those anti-whites, how we're going to work this out. Well, how we're going to work it out with the anti-whites is we're going to defeat them. Once and for all, we are going to regain and recapture our destiny as Western people, as whites. That's how we're going to work it out. There's a lot of wrong that's been done to us. And things will be right. God is our witness. And the light, the white light will prevail once again. So on that note, let's get this song rolling here. Take it out here for the evening. A little strong song with some spirit that I like, reggae style. For all the reggae lovers out there, see what we got going on. Anti-white's gonna work this out. Let's stay white positive. Western Comics. I love you all. God bless each and every one. And I will see you all soon.